It's me, Mikey Pipes, and Air Force None. What's doing? Welcome back to another fresh and exciting episode of me, Mikey Pipes, and Air Force None. People are gonna ask, "Well, where's Daniel's? Where's Daniel's son? Daniel's son's out hustling."
Yeah.
Right.
Busy.
Peter Pan. Actually, I think they're on the way to MCN to get a heat exchanger for a Ring rooftop unit. But I just wanted to remind you guys that stickers are still available. This is version 3.0. Hacks bring me stacks. And version 1, if you ain't testing, you're guessing. And this is a little late, but it's never not too late to celebrate the holidays. St. Mike, happy holidays. Stickers are available. Details in the description box down below. And last but not least, let's not forget the Bosch IDS 2.0. If you ain't testing, you're guessing. Stickers, they're free. If you want to donate to the postage fund, details in the description box down below. We're heading over to this Taj Mahal right now. They have no heat in one zone, and we're going to show Chris how we fix things, and we're going to show you how we run the show. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. I appreciate it in advance. And if you haven't done so already, consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. And when this channel grows from 31,000 subscribers to 50, we're going to have a most epic pool party on YouTube. You're not gonna want to miss it. You didn't see the tile in my master bathroom. I got a big tile too.
Yeah. What's up with this? The master bedroom's got a deadbolt on. What could be going on in there?
The doorknobs are rocking. Don't come knocking.
Ooh, nice floors. All right, heat's not working.
Yeah.
It's 71. The heat is set for 72.
That's crazy.
So heat is in heat mode. That's off, fans on auto. So let's raise it to 74. What do you think of this one? It's a nice thermostat. We put it at the carrier infinities in here.
Infinity touch.
I put these in before I fell in love with Bosch.
Yeah?
Yeah. All right, let's go upstairs. Now we're upstairs. Yeah, see, they need the elevator. It's over behind us. All right, so this air handler. It's not doing nothing. There's the filter. Let's feel the fan coil. Any temperature on this thing? Yeah, it's hot. It's hot. Little air vent right there. So, great question. Three floors below. Are those?
They're
different. This air handler is for that room we're just in, right?
Okay.
Three floors below is the boiler room. There's a chase that goes all the way down there, mm-hmm. right? So this air handler, the fan, will be controlled by this control right here, right? So if we had our tool bag, we could adjust this. But let's see. You know what you use? You don't leave home without it. What don't you leave home without? You have one of these.
Wallet, keys.
No.
No, the platinum.
You don't leave home without it.
Wait, hold on, is that a new one? I've got an old
this
one.
This is a new one.
I've got an old one.
You got an old one?
Yep.
Let's go see. Let's see yours.
It's already bent up from the same exact
thing. Oh, see? So, here's yours. Yep, see? You can tell you're a DIAC. You got an Amex Platinum card. Now, of course, you got to hold the light. We're going to see what happens if we... Oh, hold on. Let's just take that off then instead. A multi-purpose tool. Okay, now. Almost. Now. Let's see. If we adjust this fan setting, will the fan come on?
It did.
Huh. So, it sounds like we don't have good circulation. Let's put this back down to like 140 degrees. Now we're going to find out why we're not circulating water up here. So, Chris. Now we're going to go down to the mechanical room. All right. Okay, and we're gonna see what's going on. We're gonna check temperature of the boiler. We're gonna check to see if the, well, we know the circulator is running from the zone, but temperature of the boiler, pressure of the system, and we're gonna see if we got any air in the line. All right, make sure you smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. Let's get going. One flight, that's two, and three.
Let's turn the light on. Okay. So, 75 gallon. 75 gallon, baby. You look at this thing the wrong way, it may explode on you. It's Bradford White. Oh, 100 gallon.
Wow.
Damn. Don't do it. Don't do it.
I get workers' comp, right?
Shh. Yeah, mother effer. All right. Now, here's the boiler, the burler.
Okay.
All right. Now, first thing we're going to look for is, where's the flashlight? Oh, you have it. We're going to look for pressure. Right there. We have, you guys could see, it's around 20 PSI in there. Let's give it a little, let's jack it up a little bit. Okay. I'm going to jack up that pressure. And you could see someone played with expansion tanks here. They didn't put the right size in. They're just adding expansion tanks. Okay. We're at 25. All right. I want to get to like right around 30. There you go. Right? Almost there. Okay. There's our relief valve. We'll make sure that's a 30 PSI relief valve. Let's close this now. Now, let's find which zone is master bedroom. Let's go on the other side. Alright. By the way, Chris, yeah. I ordered you some. Ow!
I don't think the boss gets workers' comp, so.
You're right, I'm exempt, actually.
You're just paying yourself.
I know, I'm exempt. You guys remember, we put in this radiant for the master suite, the primary bathroom, right? Alright, so, master, MBR. And it does not feel hot, right? Kitchen, hot. Living room, off. Garage, hot. But MBR is cool. So, what we need...
Oh, wow, yeah.
A big difference, right? Now, if we feel the circulator, brief... How's it feel?
She's warm. Oh, much colder than the other ones, though. Yeah.
Kitchen, yeah. See, because we're airbound, where we're locked up. We don't have a circulation because of air. So what we need to get, we need to find a little hose.
Okay.
We have a bucket here, but we need a little hose and a bucket. All right, well, Christian is going to the truck to get a bucket and a hose. I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of education on this boiler, what components are attached to it and how they work. For starters, these green boxes, they come in different sizes, different colors. Taco, which is T-A-C-O, not taco. They're a dominant brand around here. We also have Argo. We have now Honeywell has introduced switching relays. As you can see, this is a six-zone switching relay. So every zone is essentially a thermostat. And we have one off to the side, right? This is a single zone, an SR501 one-zone switching relay. And the way this works, it gets constant power. It gets 110 volts to two inputs. And if I could, yes, I can remove that. Look at that. We have our inputs right here. So we're having 110 volts coming into this control board, this brain, this motherboard. And every circulator, as you can see here with the BX, is wired to its own from 1 through 6. Every thermostat is wired up to an associated zone, 1 through 6. So the way this works, your thermostat calls for heat. You know, it's 70 degrees in the room, it's set for 72. The zone energizes, it closes the circuit. The relay power, it gets powered by 24 volts and it sends 110 volts to the circulator and then the circulator powers up. Okay, that's essentially how this works. When a zone is calling for heat, like right now, zone number 4 is calling, we have a signal from here, right, on dry contacts that leave a terminal called XX or TT, which is right there, isolated end switch. These two connect to TT on the boiler or thermostat on the boiler. Very, very easy, right? And as long as all of the safety circuits are functional, we will have heat. Okay, this is someone added a circulator for another zone. 6 wasn't enough, so we have that there, right? Let's make sure this is good. Now, that covers the electric zoning. This is a whole another discussion, but let's talk about waterway movement. Right, this is this great thing. It's called an expansion tank. This is an Amtrol number 30. This is also an Amtrol number 30. The boiler probably needed an Amtrol number 60, but we have two 30s instead. It is what it is. Obviously, that's not my sticker. It's someone else's. It's a great guy, by the way. I'm not saying anything bad about him. He's a great plumber. These green things on top, right? These are called flow checks. right? Flow check, flow check, flow check, flow check, flow check, flow check. If we don't have flow checks in a system, like yesterday, we put in that Bosch Green Star 151 combi, right? We have the original boiler had flow checks on them, but they also had what we call IFCs. IFCs are integrated flow checks, and those get mounted inside the circulator, generally right on top of the impeller housing, right? A little plastic doodads, right? So if you don't have flow checks, if you had no flow check whatsoever, and you had multiple zones, let's say you had two zones, let's make it very simple. You'll have reverse flow, and you'll have, if one zone is on, it's actually going to pull water through the returner of the other and circulate, so you'll have heat on another zone. So I hear a lot of, you know, I hear this a lot. I have, you're a homeowner, right? You have three zones in your house. Two are space heating. One is for an indirect water heater. Indirect water heater is essentially a zone piped in off the boiler. Instead of a thermostat, you have an aquastat, right? If one of the check valves for those two zones fail, you'll have heat in that zone with the failed check valve whenever the indirect zone is firing because of reverse flow. Okay. Now that's out of the way, let's get back to the zone.
It was until I saw the second living room that was down here.
Did you find the third bathroom in the basement?
No.
Yeah, there's three bathrooms down here too. Okay, now, if a good technician is observant of his surroundings, we have a fairly big boiler. We don't really see that many of these in the average homes that we go to, but then again, we also see much bigger than this as well, right?
It's a big home.
Yes, and we also have height. With height, also means the 12 PSI. The 12 PSI of pressure that we normally have, like a small three-bedroom, 1,200 square foot ranch, obviously is not going to be sufficient enough for a four-story basement, first floor, second floor, third floor. That's four floors, right? And that piping, you saw the piping above your head. That's 4 feet. That's almost 40 feet up in the air.
Fifth floor, basically.
Yeah, basically, exactly. And the pressure was set to 20. The problem here is we don't really have enough pressure, and we're going to have to adjust the pressure reducing valve there to compensate for that. But I've offered this to them before. They'd rather pay me just once a year to come here and purge out the zone. We know this is the master bedroom, right? We know our pressure is almost at 25 PSI. So we're going to do a careful balancing act here. You're going to take the hose. One side does not have a washer on it, so we want the one with the washer on it. Oh, there's my estimate that we just left in West Hempstead. I guess he wants that Bosch... green therm. That's the one with the washer?
Yep.
Good. Okay.
Little rubber one.
Excellent. Okay. Now, you're going to hold the end of that hose just so it doesn't splash around. We're going to isolate, right? This is called a circulator isolation flange with purge. See? There's our purge. This is isolate.
Yeah.
So, like, on the jobs that we normally do, we have the circulators on the supply side because I like to believe in pumping away. We also have an isolation flange on the bottom without a purge. So if I need to change a circulator, I close this valve, close this circulator, have a nice day, right? We're going to close this valve, right? You can hold that hose. I'm going to open up this drain valve right here, which is leaking, of course, right? And then I'm going to add pressure while we're doing that, like that. And we're going to put this bucket right there in case the relief valve pops open. And we're going to see if we get any air. And we're going to wait for this to get back hot, which it's already getting hot, but no air. We may have a dead circulator.
Oh, nope, there it is.
Here comes the air. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. There's our air.
It's a clean system, too.
Yeah.
Real clean.
You know, it's a closed system, so, you know, you don't have, you know, water being constantly added to a system like a steam boiler. Wow. Which is, you know, degrading the heat exchanger.
Quite a bit of air.
Now, one other thing I'm going to do is just crack this open. If I've had any air stuck here, it's going to come out.
Wow.
Look at that. See this? Ladies and gentlemen, this is how you purge out a zone. Okay, and that water's getting hot. Because it's blazing hot here. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to close this valve. All right? We're going to open this. And then I'm going to close that fast fill valve on the pressure reducing valve, right? This is to allow me to add more pressure beyond the default, which is 12 PSI or whatever it's been set for, all right? And now, that's blazing hot. The only thing we could do now is wait to see if this cools off or not. And while we're doing that, we're waiting. We're also going to see if that air handler blower turned on. All right, so we purged out that zone. Got them heat up and running to that top floor, up three flights of stairs, and we waited.
half hour, 45 minutes, and it's still good. So we're good. Hope you watched this. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you thumbs up, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And if you want any official Pipe Doctor hat stickers, details in the description box down below. Thank you so much for watching. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.